The one evil thing the rich do against the poor. A few days ago, I was thinking about one of my businesses. We've been working and investing on this business for over a year, and now we are having some successes. And I started thinking, how can I reduce the number of hours I work on this business while I make more money? The answer to this question is simple. Create a business system and employ more people to run the system. Basically, this is what the rich do to make more money. In this video, I'll explain in detail how this game is played and how the poor are always the victims of such a game. If you're new here, consider subscribing so you won't miss other interesting videos like this. Now here's the thing. At the beginning of the 17th century, there was zero unemployment in the world. There were two reasons for that. First, because there was no public education. There was no way a few people could manipulate what we teach our kids as they have done now. Two, which is similar to the first, because there was no place where every kid will be brainwashed to love a job. It was just natural that if you were born in the 18th century, your dream will be to create your own life, either as an artist, a blacksmith, a farmer, or anything. But that was about to change. Towards the end of the 19th century, many countries of the world started influencing legislations to make public education compulsory, so every child now must go to a school. At first, the school system was highly influenced by the religious leaders, later the politicians, and finally the most influence came from the industrialists. Religious leaders have the Bible and people's obedience. Politicians have political power, but none of these could be compared to money. Because the industrialists have money, they ended up having the last laugh. By the mid-20th century, we already have a school system that is nothing but the camp to train factory workers. The industrialists influenced everything from the school curriculum to who ruled the school. At a point, one of the education heads suggested that the mathematics curriculum was supposed to make children think. To this, one of the board members replied him something like, "Our goal isn't to make them think." And that's the greatest evil the rich ever did against the poor. Let's build them a school that will train them to be our servants. That was their plan. Now back to my personal story. As you might perceive, I'm an entrepreneur, and I use people to build businesses. While employing people to work for you isn't a sin, it becomes a terrible situation when we have a society where 99.9% of people need jobs. Whenever my company announces that we have one vacant position, at least 50 people will apply for the job. The problem about this is that because there are too many people who need a job, the demand for a job is far greater than that of supply. And as a result, the stupid entrepreneurs like me have too many people begging them for jobs, and that eventually leads to the employers becoming a king who hires and fires at will, or even underpay a lot of people. This is evil, and it was not by accident. It was well planned long before any one of us was born. My advice for you. So, if you agree with me that what I'm saying is the truth, how then can you escape this trap? The solution is simple, but not many people will do it. Give yourself education. I don't care which schools you attend. I can tell you authoritatively that what you've got in a public school isn't an education. It's brainwashing at its best, because those who laid the foundation of those schools never did it to educate you. They did it to enslave you. Lillian Smith said, "Education is a private matter between the person and the world of knowledge and experience, and has little to do with school or college. Your education is a private matter between you and the world of experience. It doesn't have anything to do with a school." So, what is the component of a real education? For you to be truly educated, first, you must know who you are. The most unfortunate thing about school, next to the fact that you were trained to be a slave, is the fact that every child is taught everything at the same time and pace, and we expect every one of them to like everything we want to force into their throats because we assume that they are the same humans. Well, opposite is the truth. Every human is different, and for anyone to actually function properly among us, he or she doesn't only have to know that everyone is different, you must know what makes you different. Socrates said, "Know thyself." The first education is for you to know yourself. Know who you are, what your strengths are, and what your weaknesses are, what you do easily even though others find them difficult. You have to know how your brain works, what your temperaments are, which kinds of intelligence do you have much of. Are you a naturalist, that is, nature smart, musical, sound smart, logical, mathematical, number or reasoning smart, existential, life smart, interpersonal, people smart, bodily kinesthetic, body smart, or linguistic, word smart? It's the combination of who you are that will determine what you will have passion for. Take for instance, if you have interpersonal intelligence, then you might do well in sales or in business. If you have linguistic intelligence, you might be a great public speaker, actor, or comedian. If you have musical intelligence, there is no point trying to have A's in mathematics. If you have logical mathematical intelligence, being an inventor or a scientist may be the best thing for you. You get the point here. You must sit down and analyze yourself, your strengths and weaknesses. It's only after this you can decide what path you'll drive your life to. The second thing you should do after you've known yourself is to think like a king. Believe me, you were made to be a king. God created you to be a god, a king, a hero. But unfortunately, you've been educated to think like a servant. You can create your own life again, the exact way you want it. Don't be deceived that you need a job for 35 years. Except you love your job, you don't have to be a slave to other humans all your life. What I'm telling you here is what I'm telling my employees. Except anyone likes his job, I don't expect them to work for me for 30 years. If you wish to work for me all your life, I have no problem, but I'm going to tell you, hey, if you hate this job, plan how to get off here to what you love. The same thing is what I'm telling you here. The only reason why anyone should work for another human for 30 years is if you are treated like human with dignity and honor, plus you love your job. If you are maltreated or you hate your job, why would you remain in prison all your life? But what I've noticed in people is that they don't believe in themselves. I get it. It's a result of several years of brainwashing from the society and school. Now, I'm telling you the truth. If you think you can change your life, you can change it. I was born as a sickly boy and grew up in poverty. But when I became an adult, I started thinking about how I wanted to live my life. I wanted freedom, and I know that I would need money to get it. I went after money. I trained myself to be an entrepreneur, started businesses, failed for many years, but today I have the freedom I long desired. Though the rich have worked hard to make everyone else their slaves by influencing the kind of education you get, you don't necessarily have to be their slave for 35 years. If you think you can create your desired life, you can do it. It won't be easy, but it's possible. Thank you so much for watching our videos. Are you between the ages of 15 and 40? Then we invite you to join our new channel, which was specially created to share with you inspiration and life's lessons to succeed in life. We call it Under 40 TV. Kindly look at the description box to join the Under 40 TV. We love you.